Tell us about this comet, what it is, and might we see it today?
We won't. Spacecraft might be able to view it because it's very close to the sun. So earthbound viewers, you're not going to be able to see anything probably until Wednesday. What makes today particularly important is Comet ISON may or may not be the record breaker of comets passing the sun. The last record breaker was back in 1962. Comet Secchi-Lyons passed within 3 million miles of the sun. That was a really big deal. Well, today, Comet ISON passes about 600,000 miles from the surface of the sun. So the only thing, the only thing roasting today is your turkey. The comet's going to be roasting too.
So for those of us who don't know, what is a comet?
A comet basically is a frozen chunk of gas and water, sand, a few rocks. It's basically a very snowy dirt ball going around the sun. And it only acquires a tail when it gets close enough to the sun for the volatiles in the comet, the gases begin to sublimate. They turn from a solid into a gas.
And that's what you have in our demonstration
here, right? Yes.
So let's do that.
Put your goggles on. We're practicing safety here today. And I brought my best approximation of a comet this morning. And so I have a hunk of dry ice, and I'm going to actually put it in this beaker, which I'm going to fill with water. Now, the dry ice is about 100 degrees below zero. Mm-hmm. The water is at room temperature, so what would you predict would happen to the water?
It'll turn like a dry, icy dirt ball. Should I fill it full?
Halfway.
Halfway. Okay.
Okay. So I have my hunk of dry ice. Again, it's about 100 degrees below zero, room temperature, and most folks would predict that the water would just freeze because you have something this cold. Let's see.
And behold, Comet ISON.
Now, what's happening here is you're seeing sublimation taking place. The dry ice is turning directly from a solid to a gas. This is carbon dioxide that's flowing across the table here, which you see on movie sets and cheap science fiction shows. But basically, the bubbling you see here is not boiling, it's actually sublimating. Now, the comet is sublimating now, too. It's losing about 2 to 3 million tons of material every second today as it goes around the sun. It's hurtling around the sun at about 845,000 miles per hour. The temperature around the comet now about 5,800 degrees. That's hot enough to melt steel.
Well,
it's made of mostly that. So will it survive?
We'll see. We'll be able to have our eyes to the sky.